So I'm going to go right off of the drawing that I have here to start with and really work on getting my darks in first, which is going to be through here. I got some on the back side, and then these the pier and the pilings here, and you got a little bit through here. So that's what I'm gonna grab some medium, the burnt sienna, ultramarine blue. And rather than go in and start sketching it in paint, I'm just gonna leave it in the pencil sketch because I've got it in pretty good as far as the shape. So I'm just gonna go right in and start getting in my darks. Then I've got the other boat that it's tied up to next to it here. I'll get that one in. Just looking for the darkest parts of this painting first. Along the back here, the pier on the back side here. I'm not going to get real dark with that just yet. I don't want it to compete with everything else. But then I've got, now I'll go ahead and get some of these poles in. And using the same colors, I can go a little bit more to the burnt sienna color. So it's still dark, but a little more brown than the blue, because the boat's going to be blue. And let's see. Looks like it comes about that high. Maybe not quite. Maybe right there. think that's probably, other than I can get my shadows in a little bit here also. But I've got most of my dark areas, looks like, in. I'll just put a little bit of the shadowing in also right now, just to get a better feel for where it's going to go. So now I get a little bit better feel for what I've got. I'll move up into the dark area of the white, which isn't nearly as dark, so I'm going to use the same colors that I've got here. I'm just going to bring some white into it. But I want to keep it darker so that when I get to the front here, I can be lighter. And it might even actually be better if I wipe my brush off and go right into the lighter area and then work my way darker. So maybe I'll do that first. Because right here is probably the whitest part. So this would be the brighter part here. So I'm going to go ahead and get a little bit more white. It's still going to be grayed, but I don't want to be nearly as gray as this side. I may even add a little bit of yellow to it to brighten it. There's really no sunshine, so I don't need to get real yellow with it. But I do want it to appear a little bit brighter than everything else. And it may be a case where I come back and brighten it again at the end. So right now I'm just kind of tracing underneath where these windows are going to go. Now, as I come along the side of the boat, I'm going to get a little bit darker as I go. Just add a little bit more of the blue to it. Well, it's blue and the burnt sienna. So it's the same color, just getting a little bit more gray. And I'm still staying just under these windows here. Anywhere I see a little bit brighter, where maybe reflected light is hitting, I can go back and grab some of this little bit more yellow color to it and just paint right into it. Now I've got a doorway here. Rather than paint over it and come back, I'm just going to go right into it while I've got my sketch so I don't lose that. And I can see that that's catching a little bit of a highlight, so I'll just add a little bit more of the yellow put in there. doing is, as I'm going along, I'm looking for any subtle changes that I see in the reflections in this color. I'm also changing my sketch just a little bit. I can see the top of the boat dips down a little bit here. Sometimes with photographs, it can be hard to tell the exact color. So you may have to just exaggerate it a little bit. Because if I compare on the photograph the color along here to the color up front, it doesn't look very different. But I know the sun comes up in the morning this side and comes across. So I know it's going to be a little bit brighter and there's going to be a little bit more shadowing in here. So I need to make this a little bit darker anyway. Now this being the focal point right here, I want to make sure I have crisper lines. I can have softer edges back here, but I want them a little bit crisper up here where the focal point is. I'm not going to worry about the name just now. I probably will let this dry before I go back to that name. But I'm going to have the front of the boat here be a little bit more blue, just because that'll pull it forward. Then as I work my way back, the darkest blue I see looks like this section here, and maybe even coming back here a little bit. So I'm going to, as I paint here, just not pick up any more and allow it to blend in as I go back here. And if it gets too light, then I'll just mix up some blue and maybe touch of the black, just go right into it, get it darker, if I lose it. Then as I pick up too much of the black that I had on, I'll just go ahead and wipe my brush off a little bit more. I just want to make sure that this front here is the most blue. I see a couple spots back here, but most of this is pretty dark here. So I'm going to let most of it in this area just fade away. I'll get a little bit bolder, a little brighter with the blue up front here. But just keeping it up along the front. Because if we keep our stronger color and our sharper, crisper edges in this area and then get softer as we go back, that gives the illusion of it going the distance back. We'll get our perspective a lot better. Now that looks like it's most of the main boat here, other than we'll get the sky in before we get all that stuff in. But I'm going to work my way back here to the boats off in the distance. So I'll get a smaller brush. And I'm just going to use the colors I normally would, but just gray everything down a little bit. Because the farther you go back, the less dark shadows and the less highlights. What I'm going to do now is go to some of these background buildings, and I'm just going to do those mostly these same shades of gray. I don't want to pull them forward. I want to keep them in the back. going to do is just shape them up in different shades of gray, maybe touches of the yellow and blue, but for the most part, just some grays. That's all I'm going to do is I'm going to try to fill in this area right through here before I get to the sky. So it's, again, it's mostly just grays, some different, I think there might be another boat over here that's a little blue, has a little more blue. So I'll get that. So that's all I'm doing. I'm just looking at the photograph and seeing where I have the different shapes and colors that are back here without getting too detailed with it. That's all I'm doing. I'm basically blocking in shapes of color. If I see lines, poles, railings, I'm just kind of, I'll get those in. And even if it's not accurate, it really doesn't matter. You're just getting some of the rigging in. I might miss some. Really not, doesn't matter that much. So I'm just going to mix up a gray. Just using all these colors that I've been using. I'm going to start with the back boat, this black one. I see a lot of, that one has some black rigging. This one's got, most of it looks white. Let's see. So I'll look at where the rigging comes down and touches this boat, and that's where I got to get an idea where I started. Because now that I've painted over, I lost some of my lines. Looks like I got there. I think once you kind of get going on this, it starts to get easier. But there's a couple main poles here that I'm just trying to get in. probably it for that boat. I don't see anything else really that, yeah, I mean, I can't really identify anything else on it, so I'm just going to move right to this one. It looks like most of the rigging on this one is painted white, but we're going to keep it still gray. Maybe add a little burnt sienna to it on some of them. I see some rust on some of them. So I'm just going to keep working with these same colors. And it's got to be dark enough to show up against the sky here. So I'm going to look for, let's see, this first pole. Looks like it starts right about here. It comes up to this one here, right next to it, a little bit taller. Then the other one looks like it comes back to about right in here. Looks like it's a slight angle, taller still. Looks like about here. Let's see, comes down to about here.
That's what I'm itching for you to do, too.
Do the water?
You know, I'm real interested in the ring. However, it needs to be there.
Right.
Why does he want to do so much on the wet stone?
Because it
makes it easier for the paint to flow. If I let the sky dry, then it's skipping. The paint skips on your brush, but now that it's while it's wet, it just flows really quick and easy.
Oh, okay.
It's a better order.
Yeah, I guess you did. Yeah.
I would not want to be doing that watercolor.
See, even if you work in the sky, you're worried about wet on wet. Even if you mess up a little bit, it doesn't matter. If your lines get a little thick, wouldn't even worry about it. I'm just kind of, some of these boats back here don't have as much rigging, just some antennas. Let's get some of that in. Probably leave that like that.